Dumelang, Sanbonani, Apsheni, Luchani, here's what happened on Mobang on 25 February 2021. Imani was so upset about Vuyo being hired at Jukatole. Umagal decided to write an email and inviting people so that Mahangwani can dismiss Vuyo. Gugu was skeptical about it and asked her to promise her that this issue won't get out of hand. Imani promised him. Gugu told her that she invited Marang. Imani said she knows that they don't get along. Why did she invite her? She said she's fond of her and she's not getting involved. She made her bed, now she needs to lie on it. Mpo wanted to back off about Azwindini's issue and said Suzanne and Azwindini are like Michelle and Obama in Tati. Some women started a campaign to fight Mpo. The lawyer said she mustn't worry, she will represent her well. And I also said there's no need to panic, they will make sure she wins. Their lawyer also advised them that they need to go on social media and tell their side of the story. Buchilo was busy dancing for his music while working. Sharon was busy making deals on the phone while at work. Buchilo planned an event but failed to do other things, so he decided to tell Sharon to help. Sharon agreed and said he owes her a lot for going behind her back. Mkondo really showed Mulalo a video of Teboho on social media. Mulalo was so embarrassed by his wife and he asked her why is she ruining things for him. He also said she needs to stay out of other people's business and behave like a chief's wife. Mahangwani saw an email that was sent by Imani and asked Rendani if it was necessary. Rendani said Vuyo is a sex offender. People must know. Hangwani said Vuyo has paid for his crime. She won't allow anyone to harass her staff. Vuyo went to Mahangwani and said he's quitting because he saw an email about him. Mahangwani said she's giving him a second chance. He mustn't allow an email to get to him. James and Imani were all lovey-dovey at his office. Marang walked in on them and told Imani that her meeting is about to start. She left. James said she needs to knock. She said she's happy, she doesn't have to. He's the one who needs to knock if doing his shenanigans. James told her to respect him and he's the boss after all. KK went to Denda's house and the security tried to stop him. Denda laughed at him and said seeing him like that gives him a great pleasure. KK asked him what does he want. He said he must just sell all his shares for him. KK said it's for his son. And then Denda said the one who's the IT geek, he must just give him money so that he can open his shop. KK got so pissed and almost beat Denda and said he must never make a mistake of touching his son. He will regret it. And then he left. Suzanne was reading a book. Azwindini asked her what is it about. She said it's about love, family and betrayal. Azwindini asked to join her. She said it's her day off. She would love to spend it in peace. Azwindini apologized for failing her. Suzanne said everything she does, it's for him. Now he's asking that little that they have. Azwindini said he realized that. Suzanne said it's okay. They both going through a rough time. Azwindini smiled and said he wonder sometimes what did he do to deserve her. She said he loved her. That's all that matters. And then after said she doesn't think Mpo will continue with the case after that video that was posted on social media. Teboho really embarrassed him. Marang was really upset and went to Rendani. Rendani asked her why she's still working for James after what happened. She said it's tough out there. Companies are retrenching. Marang apologized for always taking it out to Rendani. Rendani said it's fine. She doesn't have to apologize. Marang told her that it was going to be easy if she had to deal with James. But now she has to deal with that Delilah. And said she went to see James. Rendani wasn't happy about it and said she thought she was done with James. Marang said she knows. She thought maybe James missed her too. But from now on she's done with James. While they were sitting at Dukatole, Imani came with her gang toy-toying for Mahangwani and making noise, saying Vuyo must go. The receptionist lady was busy taking a video. Things were not going well between Sharon and Buchilo. Buchilo is failing to get a venue. Sharon said it's his job. And then after Shaz saw a video of Imani busy protesting at Dukatole and she couldn't believe it. Buchilo said they will use Dukatole and Mahangwani won't even charge them a cent. Marang tried to stand up for Mahangwani and said Imani needs to stop ruining Vuyo's life and he's trying to make money for a living. Vuyo told Imani that he's changed. It didn't stop right there. Imani and others attacked the guy and threw eggs on Vuyo. Gugu came and told them to stop this nonsense. She took Imani and left. Mpo told her side of the story on social media and said Susan and Azwindini married on a civil union. Mahangwane and her kids were watching. Buchilo said it's all an act. She hid his affair with his uncle for months. Rendani said she sounds sincere. She's angry at Azwindini. If Hulisani can do that, he will see flames. Bumahangwane said words have power. She mustn't say that. Sharon said she deserves it. He is attending therapy because of her. She took the man of her best friend. Buchilo said she has a history of stealing men. Rendani told them that they are boring her. Bomahangwane said they need to stop talking about who cheated. Mpo is married to wealth and now she wants to take everything for Susan and Azwindini while they are poor. Imani was hell mad because Gugu stopped her protest. Gugu said she promised in the morning that she won't go that far, but she attacked Bomahangwane and Vuyo and threw them with eggs. And that's not what she said earlier. She said she doesn't understand Hangwane. How could she hire a pervert? Gugu said Hangwane is fair. She's just being a bully. Imani admitted that she was wrong and said she allowed the anger to control her. What must she do now? Because she was humiliated about her sex tape. Gugu said she will always support her, but she mustn't behave like that. And she hopes that Vuyo and Mahangwane don't open a case against her. Buchilo told Sharon that she wants to visit his parents, at least for a week. Thank you so much for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you can get more episodes on this channel. 105 Online Channel loves you. Bye, good people.